Curious Droid presents 5 smallest man-made objects. The sculptures created by Jonty Hurwitz and his team, like this piece called The Gentle Giant, have now reached such a microscopic scale that they even had to create a whole new method of filming just to show them, because they are now so small that you can't see the fine details in normal visible light. You have to remember that this elephant sculpture is just 1/10 of a millimetre high, and yet you can still see the fine details of the wrinkles on the skin. This and the other nano sculptures, including the one called Trust, the world's smallest sculpture of a woman, which is shown standing on a human hair, are made using a nano 3D printer technique called multiphoton lithography. This is where they use tiny layers of a light-sensitive liquid polymer, which are laid down one layer at a time and then hardened with a focused laser. The smaller details on these works are at approximately the 300 nanometer scale, similar to the wavelengths of visible light, and are therefore near impossible by the laws of physics to see in the visible light spectrum. The only way to observe these works fully is through using a non-optical method of magnification, like a scanning electron microscope. One of the problems with sculptures which are so small is not only that you can't see them, but they can be destroyed or lost very easily. And in fact, the sculpture of Cupid and Psyche, shown here, which was shown on the head of an ant, was accidentally destroyed by a single touch just a week before their publication on the internet. Now, if you thought the previous sculptures were pretty amazing, then the next ones on the list will blow your mind. Willard Wigan creates the smallest handmade sculptures in the world, figures so small that they can stand in the eye of a needle. In fact, the very smallest sculpture he has made is of a motorcycle inside a hollowed out shaft of Willard's own beard stubble. And don't forget, these are made by hand, not by computer or robot or 3D printer, but all by hand. These microscopic works of art sell for hundreds of thousands of dollars, and collectors include the likes of Prince Charles, Elton John, Simon Cowell, and Mike Tyson. Willard's work has been described as phenomenal and the 8th wonder of the world, and in July 2007 he was awarded an MBE by the Queen. In order to make these amazing sculptures, Willard has had to make his own micro tools using things like a sharpened microscopic sliver of tungsten, or by attaching a shard of diamond to a pin to carve the figures, and then using the hair from a housefly as a paintbrush. To make these tiny sculptures, Willard uses a 600 times magnification microscope and enters an almost meditative state, slowing his heartbeat and then doing the particular action between the heartbeats to keep his hand as steady as possible. One of the problems of working on such tiny objects is a danger of even seemingly tiny external forces ruining the work. And one of these was the vibration caused by the traffic passing his workshop, so he ended up working throughout the night when it was quieter. However, when working on one sculpture of Alice in Wonderland, he accidentally breathed in too hard and the work was gone. So this is not a job you can do if you suffer from hay fever or sneezing fits. We've seen nano motors before, but now the Cockerill School of Engineering at the University of Texas has created a motor under 1 micrometer in size, which is 500 times smaller than a grain of salt and small enough to fit inside a human cell. Now that might seem pretty amazing enough on its own, but this nano-sized motor is capable for running up to 15 continuous hours at 18,000 revolutions per minute. That's the speed of a turbine in a jet engine. The power to run the motors comes from first an induced DC current to assemble the three-part motor, and then from an AC current to operate the motor. The tiny motor has been successfully designed, assembled, and tested in a non-biological environment, and has performed 3 tasks. It can move through liquids and can both mix and pump biochemicals at the same time. The idea is that it could deliver a controlled amount of a drug directly to the affected cells. To test its drug delivery capabilities, the researchers coated the surface with biochemicals. The faster the motor spun, the faster the drugs were released. Ultimately, these tiny motors could be used in nanomachines that would be not much bigger than the normal cells and could be used to target things like cancer cells directly. We're used to seeing computers getting smaller and more powerful, but the biggest stumbling block to making truly tiny computers is that whilst the physical components can be shrunk, the power required is still quite high. So even a tiny computer would need a big battery in comparison. The breakthrough came in 2008 when the Phoenix processor was created, which used a fraction of the power of previous processors and allowed much smaller self-contained computers to be created. The Michigan Micromote is currently the world's smallest computer at just 2 millimeters by 4 millimeters and requires an average of just 500 picowatts in operation and just 35 picowatts in standby, or about 1 millionth of the power of a mobile phone on standby. The Michigan Micromote has a processor, a radio for Wi-Fi communications, a solar cell and battery for power, a photocell for communications, and can have a variety of sensors like pressure, temperature, and imaging, making the Micromote a fully self-contained computer that can run on just the normal lighting in a room. No physical connections are required because it can be programmed by picking up a high-frequency strobe light signal from its photocell or via the two-way Wi-Fi, which has a current range of 2 meters, but the makers are looking at extending the range of up to 20 meters. The applications for these tiny computers range from implantable medical chips and smart sensors to security and information devices. Ever since the beginning of their existence, the makers of robots have taken the inspiration from nature, whether it be in the form of a man or from nature's other wonders like insects. Up until recently, technological limitations have prevented robots from matching the size of real-life insects. RoboBee has been 14 years in the making. When it was first announced, it could fly for just a few seconds before crashing. Now it can hover along a preset path, and recently the team at Harvard have shown that they can also get it to swim underwater by using a modified flapping technique which was inspired by the puffin's ability to go from flying to swimming as they dive for fish. The micro robot, which is 2 centimeters in length and weighs just 80 milligrams, still has to fly with a tether to provide it with power because there are still no batteries small enough to fit yet powerful enough to make it fly. The wings and body are made from flat layers of laser-cut carbon fiber, hinged together with embedded plastic, which are then folded into three-dimensional frames instead of being pieced together by hand. In practice, this works much like the pages of a pop-up book, reducing the complexity and the time required in making these tiny robots. It uses piezoelectric actuators, which are thin strips of ceramic which expand and contract under an electric field to serve as the wing muscles. These beat independently at 120 times per second for flying in air, which is reduced to just 9 times a second when it swims through water. The next stage of the research will be to do the reverse, like birds and beetles can do when they take off from the water and fly into the air. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, then don't forget to please thumbs up and subscribe for more. And if you have any ideas for videos you'd like to see, then please let us know in the comments below.